I wonder.
Any buck you want to go?
That's where it started.
Kellen, righto Kellen, you're off on a 10-yard handicap with Eithelman. So we'll just have up and down the track starters and we'll get on with this race because there's no betting, we don't have to wait. So we've got Kellen there with Ethan Hope and you're off go with Beacon Sorcerer, Ellie. Okay? Please, or I won't let you go. Nice and steady. Okay? If somebody had dropped their arm when they come by that 30 yard. 3, 2, 1, go! 1, 2, well done girls, lovely start for me, nice and easy. So we go into the first bend of the junior race at Presteigne, and in front is Beacon Sorcerer, and closely followed by Ethan Hope. It's a nice steady pace at the moment, both drivers getting to know the track. But it looks like Ethan Hope wants to go a little bit quicker. And he's taking a hold and making ground on Beacon Sorcerer. Into the back straight they go for the first time. And at the moment they're going on a Sunday morning to church pace. And it's in front we've got Beacon Sorcerer. Beacon Sorcerer leads from Ethan Hope in second. But Ethan Hope makes ground on the outside. I think the driver's waiting for a fast finish here and just keeping hold. But it's Beacon Sorcerer and Ellie Bevan in front of Kellen James on Ethan Hope. Into the Cumb Bend we go for the first time. And Beacon Sorcerer's decided to get on with this. He's gone 2-3 lengths clear. But Ethan Hope again closes the gap quite easily when he's just given a little bit, an inch of rain. Onto the home straight they come. Beacon Sorcerer still in the lead. It's a long way round here to laps around Presteigne Common and they're taking their time. But Ethan Hope pulls to the outside and may have just come to the front now. It's on the inside, Beacon Sorcerer on the outside, Ethan Hope. And they're neck and neck, they're going for it. And it's Ethan Hope who takes the lead. Ethan Hope leads, Beacon Sorcerer in second place. Quite nice. A nice manoeuvre there by the driver of Ethan Hope to get to the front. It's Ethan Hope with a 2-length lead. Into the Presteigne Bend for the second and final time. Ethan Hope just holding that 2-length lead. Ellie's getting a little bit urgent now on Beacon Sorcerer, trying to close the gap. Out of sight they go. And waiting for him to come back into view. And it's Elite Hope, but Beacon Sorcerer is the one now gaining. Ethan Hope in front. Beacon Sorcerer in second place. They're halfway down the back straight for the final time. Into the Cumb Bend. And we've still got Ethan Hope in front. Ethan Hope by a length, but I'm sure Beacon Sorcerer will challenge in the home straight. Round the bend they go. Ethan Hope corners really well, gets 2 lengths. I can see owner trainer Andrew Bevan just getting slightly excited on down the course there. He's beginning to urge you in. And halfway up the home straight now, Ethan Hope, but Ellie pulls Beacon Sorcerer out for a run. There's going to be a finish here. Ethan Hope in front, but Beacon Sorcerer's coming. Beacon Sorcerer's doing the best he can. Oh, just broke there, leading Ethan Hope. Ethan Hope wins it. Beacon Sorcerer, just that little mistake may have cost in the race. What a terrific race between the two juniors. Well done, girls. Thank you for putting on that entertainment, and if the crowd, please put their hands together and show their appreciation of these two youngsters when they come back into the enclosure. I think it was probably one of the, I don't think that Kellen has driven very often, because there's a magnificent trophy given every year for this championship. So all your other youngsters, get yourself a horse and get out and have a go, and he's really very happy. Congratulations. Well done with Ethan Hope. We've now got the great